You're talking about linear time invariant system in the context of inputs and outputs being a stochastic process, so we want to be able to analyze it. So if you have a linear system, the mean of the output, so here let's say x of t is given to your linear system, and then you have y of t. So this linearity is inherited to so the combined with this expectation, because expectation operator is a linear operator, and then you could change it. So you could always say that expected value of y of t, so this is equal to expected value of y of t. And because this is a linear operation, you could change the order of these two guys and say this one. Otherwise, in other words, the expected value of the input, which could be time varying, if you apply it to all, you get expected value of y of t. So the proof for LTI systems is much easier. For LTI system, you know that x of t convolved with h of t gives you y of t. And this is just an integral of x of t minus alpha d alpha, sorry, h of alpha and then d alpha. And alpha varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. If you calculate mean of that expected value of this guy, that means that you have to calculate expected value of this guy, okay? And expected value is just another integral. So integral over distributions and so on. So you could change the order of these two integrals and put expected value of that. So this will become expected value of alpha from minus infinity to plus infinity. And expected value of this is mu x of t h of alpha d alpha. So this is for this case, and this is equal to mu of x of t convolved with h of t. Okay, so this expression is same as this one. So now, if you have an LTI system, if you give x of t the input to an LTI system, the output y of t is just x of t convolution with h of t. Now, if you want to calculate cross correlation of the input and output, so let's say R, Y, X, Y of let's say T1 and T2. So this is expected value X at time T1 and Y at time T2. Because I have the expression for Y of time T2, I get expected value of X of T1. And then the second one is just equals, because this is integral over alpha from minus infinity to plus infinity of X of T minus alpha, H of alpha, D alpha. Obviously, if they are complex, you remember to put a conjugate there. If not, you don't need to put it there. So, and then you have integral alpha from minus infinity to plus infinity of x of t minus alpha and h of alpha d alpha. Okay? So this, I could put it inside the integral. Okay? So this become expected value of integral alpha from minus infinity to plus infinity x of t1 and then x of t minus alpha and then h of alpha d alpha. Okay, now because this is not random, this boundary is not random, I could put this expectation, which is expectation is an integral, change the order of these two integral and put it inside. If I put it inside, this will become expected value of these two guys. Now, this one is Rxx at time t and t1 and t minus alpha, and then h of alpha d alpha. And then you have to put integral over the dummy variable of alpha from minus infinity to plus infinity. Dummy variables means a variable which disappears after integration. So I summarize, rewrite it nicely, and then you put this is just a convolution, and then change the order and put this one inside the integral, and then you could change the order. And then this will become rxx. Now you see that this is just a convolution over the second argument. Remember that t1 is constant, so it's kind of like what you need to. So similarly, if you do that, you could replace this one by one integral, this one by another integral. You will see that this is going to be the first one is going to be a convolution, and then you will have two convolutions, one for the first one, one for the second one. Remember here that here I assume that the second one I need to put a conjugate, and here I didn't put it. Here I should have put a conjugate on this one and on this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, if they are complex. But if not, then you don't need, and then in this case you'd have a conjugate here. So in that case, if you follow the same steps, you get this result, and obviously you will get. So the autocorrelation of the output with itself will have the cross correlation of input and output, and obviously this guy is already calculated in this expression, okay? So this can go there and become false. So in order to get the autocorrelation of the output with the outputs, I need to calculate first convolution of the input with h of t2. Obviously, if they're complex, you put a conjugate on this one, and then another convolution with the first time instance. So we can do that. So we see that the moments of the output, or the cross moments of the output and input, they can be calculated as the in terms of the expression of the moments of the input only.